Today we're talking about the new record weight from Groovewasher. Does it work? Does it make a difference? Stay tuned to find out, coming up right after this. Channel 33, RPM. Hi, my name is Frank. Welcome back to Sundays on Channel 33 RPM, your channel for vinyl, gear, and more. Big shout out to Steve and the crew over at Groovewasher for sending me over this record weight and some other goodies I'll show you in a second to check out. Now, I've been a fan of Groovewasher for a couple of years, ever since I tried out their record cleaning brush. Now, these guys are not sponsoring this video. They're not paying me to say this, but I gotta tell you, in my opinion, this is the best record cleaning brush on the market today, bar none. So with that, when I got this record weight, my expectations were pretty high. What did I think of it? Well, let's get into that right now. As I mentioned off the top, those guys sent me over a box of goodies here. I'll quickly show you some of the items. They sent me over the Commando kit. This is for cleaning vinyl, sort of a budget version compared to the brush I just showed you. They sent me over some of these cool and groovy Groovewasher coasters. So that's kind of cool. What else is in here? They sent me over the Groovewasher SC1 stylus cleaning kit. Very important, if not critical, to make sure your stylus is clean. And they sent me this wood block, which you use to store the brush, the fluid, and of course there's a little spot here, I believe, for the stylus cleaner. Anyway, that's some cool stuff in the box, but we are here to talk about the Groovewasher record weight. And I made a note here, this is 14 ounces of milled aluminum with a felt base, so that is a little less than a pound, so there's some nice weight to it. Nice packaging here as well. Let's give this a quick open. There we go. It comes in this nice black box, which is good for storing, should you ever want to store it. Inside, there we go. There is the record weight, as I said. It's got some good heft to it right there. And there's a felt bottom. And yeah, that's the packaging. Let's wander over to the turntable and see what it looks like in action. This weight works simply by placing it on top of your record, which couples the vinyl closer to your turntable's platter. This dampens or reduces vibrations, which can result in cleaner playback and less distortion. As well, the additional platter mass may reduce wow and flutter. Wow and flutter are basically those annoying variations in pitch which you may hear when playing a record. So how does this work? How does a record weight potentially at least reduce wow and flutter? Well, the way I understand it, it comes down to physics. The greater the mass of the platter, the higher the inertia, or the more likely the record is to spin at a consistent speed. Finally, the additional weight may help flatten thinner records, those ones with a slight warp. Note though, the primary purpose of the record weight is not to fix warps. Now, I know the vinyl community is kind of torn on the benefits of record weights. Some people claim that they make a difference, and others consider record weights to be nothing more than snake oil for audiophiles. Now, I've been using this particular record weight now for a couple of weeks. I've been using it on two of my turntables, including my Project Debut Carbon right over there with the acrylic platter, as well as my vintage Hitachi PS48. And here's my take on the record weight. First, I have noticed an improvement in sound quality. It's subtle, but it is noticeable. It's most pronounced in the bass response. The bass is a bit tighter and a bit deeper. That's my impression anyway. Second, as I mentioned previously, the record weight does help flatten slightly warped records, especially, as I said, the thinner ones from the 70s and 80s. The 180 gram ones, nah, not so much. Third, the weight helps hold the record down. It reduces slippage. I've noticed this when manually cleaning records, especially on the acrylic platter. The record is less likely to slip. Finally, and this is entirely subjective, 33ers, but I think the record weight looks cool. It's been a permanent fixture on my turntable ever since I got it. Now, a word of caution about record weights. Check your owner's manual. Check the manual that came with your turntable to make sure that it can handle the additional weight. Now, it's only a pound or so, or less than a pound, but it can make a difference. As it says here on the box, not recommended for budget turntables, as well as this warning to follow turntable manufacturer's instructions. Now, in most cases, from what I understand, there should not be an issue. And I made a note of this just to make sure I told you guys, but I have read warnings online about the additional weight causing problems and potential damage to turntable motors, belts, and bearings over time. I have not experienced any issues in my brief time with the record weight, but again, check your owner's manual, please. Okay, here is my bottom line. Using a record weight like this one is not going to dramatically improve your listening experience. It's not a day and night difference. It is far more subtle than that. As I mentioned earlier, what I noticed most was an improvement in the bass response, but again, it was subtle. If you're looking for more dramatic ways to improve your listening experience, there are other ways to do that. For example, buying a new cartridge. Of course, that's gonna cost you a lot more than a record weight, but that will also make more of a difference in the quality of sound coming from your speakers and coming from your turntable. This record weight and record weights in general, I think, are more suited for the record collector who's already got a decent turntable and is looking for incremental ways to improve their listening experience. This is another cool gadget to add to your stash of tools. And I mean, at the cost, the price of it is $50. It's not a huge investment for that price. I definitely think it's worth checking out. Okay, 33ers, that is my take on the record weight. What do you guys think? Have you tried this particular model? Have you tried a different model? Have you noticed a difference? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Remember, if you enjoyed today's video, to leave a quick like. If you haven't subscribed, click the subscribe button wherever it is so you never miss another episode. Again, dear 33ers, thank, I'm tongue-tied. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your patience. I hope you have a fantastic week. Until next time, keep on spinning.